Most people think the car market is split into two camps, electric vehicles on one side and everything else on the other. And it's already obvious that the everything else category is increasingly dominated by hybrids. But what's changed and what most people haven't noticed is the type of hybrid taking over. The old idea, a slightly more efficient ICE car, is being replaced by something very different, an EV at its core with the hybrid label giving it wider appeal. When people hear hybrid, they think Prius, combination of a combustion engine first car with a small battery added to help out. That's not what I'm talking about. EV hybrids are the reverse, an electric vehicle with a combustion engine added to extend range. In normal driving, they're an EV. The engine isn't there to replace the battery, it's there to support it. The label hybrid matters because different buyers react very differently to the labels. There's those who only want full EVs. Others who are open to EVs but cautious about current infrastructure and cost. And then some who reject EVs entirely but will happily accept a hybrid. Full EVs already satisfy EV enthusiasts, that first group. But that group's small and not expanding rapidly. EV hybrids take the same EV benefits and extend them to the rest while providing backup range for cautious buyers and the hybrid label for those not yet ready to embrace a full EV. With falling battery prices giving EV hybrids cost advantage over regular gas cars, the market's responding rapidly. At the start of 2025, EV hybrids were offered by just two of the global top 10 automakers, the fastest growing ones, BYD and Geely. Today, all but one of the top 10 either has them on sale or has announced plans to launch them. In the US alone, brands have gone from zero range extender EV hybrids to 20 models announced as in progress for release. It's not because EVs have stopped working, although in part it's because selling them has become more complex. And in China, while giants BYD and Geely are current leaders, brands previously EV-only, including XPeng, NIO, Zeekr, Xiaomi and Avatr, have all launched or announced EV hybrids. These aren't companies trying to avoid electrification, they're just companies trying to scale it. EV hybrids solve several problems at once. They nullify range anxiety, break the charging infrastructure deadlock, allowing EV adoption and infrastructure to grow together. They allow a shift from refueling to charging to unlock the savings without forcing it, and they can be labelled hybrid. Yes, some brands have pushed back full EV targets, and the EU has delayed the sunset of hybrids. But it doesn't mean the EV takeover is slowing. It means some EVs are now coming with a range extender and a hybrid badge as EV hybrids. In the EU, there are already rules to limit the use of the range extender. Making it truly emergency only everywhere is the next step, and a very solvable one. And those falling battery prices mean these EV hybrids can already cost less than traditional gas cars.